I feared for my life. Like, I was completely powerless in this situation. They didn't acknowledge my EMT identity. They didn't acknowledge my uniform.
So attempting to save lives is now dangerous territory.
This is a traumatic life experience for me.
On August 22nd, Dearden was in the middle of an emergency transport. In the back of the ambulance was this LAPD sergeant. Dearden and a patient who was reportedly having a seizure and had possibly been the victim of a sexual assault.
What I did was I laid her down supine, so flat, and I tightened up the safety belts. Due to her flailing body nature, I needed to tighten her down. It's a safety hazard in the moving ambulance.
Dearden says the sergeant accused him of assaulting the patient.
By me physically restraining her, just doing my job, it was a necessity because the patient was becoming a danger to herself.
The sergeant then called for backup. Officers arrived and arrested Dearden.
This is EMT Royce Dearden. He was treating a patient who was allegedly suffering from a seizure in an ambulance. Well, that was up until an officer aboard saw this man's efforts to restrain the patient for her own safety as an assault, resulting in him being surrounded, weapons drawn, arrested, and charged with assault for doing his job.
Very fearful situation. I didn't know it was a taser at the time. All I see is a weapon in my face.
Yeah, you hear it and you go, that's not believable that they would arrest somebody that absolutely did nothing except his job.
Well, this is the only part of this video I wouldn't agree with, thinking this isn't believable, because unfortunately, and at times tragically, it all too often is.
A Hispanic officer shot and wounded an unarmed black man. The victim was a mental health worker who was trying to return an autistic patient to a group home.
See the shooting of a behavioral therapist named Charles Kinsey in July of 2017, for example.
Jamel Robertson, the bouncer on duty, was allegedly trying to apprehend a suspect when an officer opened fire, killing him.
Or see the shooting of Jamel Robertson, a security guard in Chicago who apprehended a shooter before being shot by police arriving on the scene. So it's not a surprise, but that doesn't make it any less shocking. And here's the thing, when I saw this video circulating, I of course commented first on my Instagram and then shared it around with friends of mine, most of them who had that same initial shock and disbelief. And I don't blame people for not being up to date on every incident that occurs. But for some to say this is just a one-off accident, that right there is downplaying the issue and minimizing its severity. This could have cost this man his life, all because he sought to help save someone else's. When Jamel Robertson instinctively apprehended a would-be shooter in Chicago, he was doing his job also, and it did cost him his life. But yet, even after that, when I commented on that situation, I heard the same thing. It's just a mistake, you're blowing this out of proportion. I mean, how many mistakes can we see before we realize there is a connecting issue in how people of color are perceived as a threat when simply trying to do their jobs? Just last week, there was a video of a woman stalking a UPS worker because she said he looked suspicious. These are not isolated one-off occurrences. They happen every day, and only a few get videotaped. So when they do appear, they must be discussed and the issue itself addressed and not downplayed.